Right now I'm seeing how high this fan will go, or if it even does go up.
So today we're looking at how to measure electricity. So we've been looking at multimeters, which is the tool that you use to measure electricity in volts and things like that. So the kids have now been able to have a play with circuits and then measure how much is coming through with different amounts of batteries.
So it's kind of really challenging, making a mind actually switch on to figure it out.
Yeah, it's kind of hard.
The switching, so where do you think the switching's going to go?
It's wonderful working with the children. They're excited, they're innovative, they're actually asking me really cool questions. I get a little bit nervous each week because I don't know what questions that they're going to ask me.
She's good at science and I like science a lot.
I've never seen ones like these before. They're actually, you know, made for kids to use in school. So that I suppose the most difficult things for the kids today and something that they actually learn is that they've actually got to put the red to the positive and the black to the negative. So actually going to learn about positive, negative, and they're also going to learn about voltage as well.
This is a multimeter, which measures the amount of voltage in the battery or in the circuit.
No. When someone would mention insulator, I just had a blank face.
So voltage is an electromotive force of potential difference.
So I've actually bought some safety gear for them to try on today and to have a look at what they use and ask some questions about why we actually use safety gear when people are working on the grid.
And you've had short gloves. What could happen?
From here we start looking at electricity generation, and we're going to eventually look at making our own network. And so yeah, we've got the two 3D printers, trying to print as much as we can, so we're printing lots of different batteries and solar panels, wind turbines and things like that. So.
It's really fun. I used to not be that interested in all that stuff. Like if someone said, oh wow, look at this, like it's a circuit, I'd be like, oh cool, but now I'm actually quite interested.
They've definitely come a long way from where they began in terms of knowledge and also enthusiasm towards learning. They want to know more, they want to know how it works.
I might work at Western Power, I don't know. It's just that I think that some jobs might have been taken over by robots in the future. So I'm pretty desperate to know if Western Power is going to be taken over by robots. Probably not.